Good morning. And Merry Christmas. Welcome to Holy Cross Church. A warm welcome to our faithful parishioners. I want to wish and thank the faithful for making our parish what it is today, a beacon of hope, not only for the parishioners, but for this community. A special welcome to parishioners and guests who might be joining us for the first time, or maybe for the first time in a while. We're pleased and blessed that you chose to spend some of your Christmas with us here. We ask you to prayerfully open your hearts to baby Jesus today, and consider joining us at Mass in the future. Truly missed, and wish you to know that you're always welcome here. God bless each and every one of you, and Merry Christmas. Let's celebrate.
Merry Christmas. And a very warm welcome to all of our parishioners and to all those who may be visiting. The celebrant of this Mass is Father Gagnier.
Our opening hymn is Hark the Herald Angels Sing in the Green Book. It's number 348. It does have a little twist. There's an extra little refrain in here that's a little different, and we will lead you, and hopefully you'll join in singing that part as well.
Honor, then mercy, fire, God and Good morning.
Good morning.
And Merry Christmas to you all.
Merry Christmas.
We begin our celebration of the Holy Eucharist in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God the Father, and the unity of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My brothers and sisters, as we prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, we call to mind our need for God's mercy. In the front of the red book, Penitential Act A. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who wonderfully created the dignity of human nature and still more wonderfully restored it, grant, we pray, that we may share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing, as they rejoice before you as at the harvest, as people make merry when dividing spoils. For the yoke that burdened them, the pole on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaster, you have smashed, as on the day of Midian. For every boot that tramped in battle, every cloak rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for flames. For a child is born to us, a son is given us. Upon his shoulder, dominion rests. They name him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and ever peaceful, from David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Good morning and Merry Christmas. The psalm this morning can be found on page 91 in the Green Gather Hymnal. It is Psalm 96, Today is Born Our Savior.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to Titus. Beloved, the grace of God has appeared, saving all and training us to reject godless ways and worldly desires, and to live temperately, justly, and devoutly in this age, as we await the blessed hope, the appearance of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to deliver us from all lawlessness and to cleanse for himself a people as his own, eager to do what is good. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to the Lord.
In those days a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the whole world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment when Quirinius was governor of Syria. So all went to be enrolled, each to his own town. And Joseph too went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David that is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were shepherds in that region living in the field and keeping the night watch over their flock. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were struck with great fear. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For today in the city of David a Savior has been born to you, who is Christ and Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was a multitude of the heavenly host with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
They name him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. These words of the prophet Isaiah are familiar to us also from the Messiah, an oratorio written by George Frederick Handel in 1741, written in just 24 days. For many years, the work was not well received. At the time, it was considered unbecoming to have professional actors singing words from the Bible. Yet 13 years later, it was presented by Handel at the new chapel of the Foundling Hospital in London. It was a sellout. In order to have more room in the chapel, the men were asked to leave their swords at home, and the women not to wear their hoop skirts. Anybody have any hoop skirts? Or swords today? I don't think so. Well, Handel continued to direct his work as a fundraiser for the rest of his life. And now we know the Messiah as one of the most beautiful musical compositions of all time. In the same way, the birth of the real Messiah, Jesus Christ, went unnoticed by most of the world. The first to hear the news were poor shepherds. Then wise men came from the east to bring their homage and their gifts. The authorities considered the child to be a threat, so much so that the family had to flee to Egypt until the death of King Herod. Jesus grew up in a quiet way in the backwaters of Nazareth. At the age of 12, he attempted to begin what became his life's work. Yet Mary and Joseph knew that this boy, for all his supposed wisdom at the temple, would not be taken seriously, and so they took him back home. Not until he was 30, after the death of his earthly father, did Jesus begin the work of his heavenly Father, the work that he was sent to do, and that is to reconcile humanity and divinity in himself. The coming of Jesus, along with his passion, death, and resurrection, accomplished more than all the words of the major and minor prophets. It brought about the forgiveness of our sin and the promise of a life that would never end. There is a story that illustrated this well. Like the parables of Jesus, it makes a point. Deacon Dick Lombard says, "All my stories are true, and some of them actually happen." Well, this story, too, is just like that. It seems that in the Philippines, there was a little girl who claimed that God talked to her. She was brought to the cardinal. He said, "If God talks to you, ask him what my sins were in my last confession." A week later, she came with her answer. "God said, I forgot." And this proves the point. It says in Psalm 103, "As far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed our sins from us." Once a person in confession told me of something from their far past that was confessed many times, and yet this person could not find peace. I said, "God is not the problem here. God has long since forgiven you. You need to forgive yourself, and then you will find peace." And so it was. We are the ones who carry around past hurts and grudges and beat ourselves up with them. In doing so, we ourselves are standing in the way of God's free offer of love given through Jesus Christ. Jesus came as our Messiah. Messiah in Hebrew means the anointed one. In Greek, the word is Christos or Christ. Jesus is a name, Christ is a title. Whatever we call this child born in our midst, we call upon him to continue to bless our parish with growth and with closeness to God, and the ability to bring others into our family of faith. So we thank you all for being here today and ask God to bless you all in this season. If you didn't get a bulletin yet, we ask you to please take one now. On the insert page in the bulletin, it mentions at the top our desire to ask you to share with us your phone number. And there's a simple reason for this. Many people, unlike the rectory office, have moved from a landline to a cell number. And this makes our parish records very outdated. So we simply ask that you will correct that for us in the weeks to come. A year ago Christmas, I would not have expected to be standing here among you. I never expected to come back from the country to Monroe County. But by the will of God and the desire of the Bishop of Rochester, I am honored to be part of this wonderful community of Holy Cross to continue the good work that we do in bringing the message of Jesus Christ to Shalott and the surrounding area. And in doing so, I express great thanks to the many, many people who make possible what we do in our parish. The many volunteers, our wonderful musicians, lectors, and Eucharistic ministers. It's all kinds of people who make the parish work day by day. It is all of us, whatever we do, who as God's people bring the message of the newborn Savior to the world. For his message brings us nothing less than an inheritance that will never end, the gift of life eternal. Please stand. In the front cover of the red book, we have our Nicene Creed as we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins and the life of the world to come. Amen. We join now in our prayer of the faithful, asking God to hear these, our intentions.
For the church, may the birth of our Savior be joyfully proclaimed and transform the world through word and deed. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That light and peace may reign in the hearts of nations and families. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families, may we all welcome the Christ child into our homes and experience his blessings and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish family, that as we grow as one church, one family, we will keep alive the faith, hope, and love of Christmas with each other all throughout the year. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God may touch those who are searching and lead them to rejoice in his love and mercy, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, that God may give them courage and strength, and for all those who have died, that they are celebrating Christmas in heaven with Christ our King, and for your special Christmas intentions for which this Mass is offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pause for a moment and make our own private petitions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, you hear the prayers of your people who come before you this day. Answer us in the name of Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen.
The collection today is your special Christmas offering.
As our gifts are brought to the table, please join in singing number 363 in the Green Book, O Little Town of Bethlehem, and we will sing into Silent Night, and that's number 352. So number 363 and number 352 in the Green Book.
Oh. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my life and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our believing in all holy church.
Make acceptable, O Lord, our oblation on this solemn day, when you manifested the reconciliation that makes us wholly pleasing in your sight, and inaugurated for us the fullness of divine worship through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up to him in love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim in song. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior, oh.
bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Salvatore our Bishop, and all the clergy and religion. Remember also our brothers and sisters, especially those of our parish family, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Jesus, Lamb of God.
Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word,